Today TV. I'm Lauren.
And I'm Lena.
And today's April Fool's Day.
Yeah, happy April Fool's.
Before we get started, don't forget to head to iTunes and you can actually vote for our show there and you can give us 5 stars.
No joke.
You should do that. Okay, starting off, I wanted to show just a minute or so of this video. This organization, it's a nonprofit, it's called City Year. And it's basically, it's kind of like Teach for America,
yeah.
Where they take kids straight out of college and put them into schools that are maybe in need or are not in great neighborhoods, and they just kind of throw them in there, get them experience with the children and education and helping out that way. And I actually have a friend who's doing it, so
oh, that's great.
I didn't notice until after I watched the video, but the video is really great. It kind of goes through some of the participants and it gives their opinions and how they think the program is. So I want to just play a minute of one of them so you can see.
Well, so I work on my plans for the future as well. What have you learned so far in your first 3 months or 4 months now?
I was thinking about this last night, actually. When I come into the classroom, I'm from a very white, very homogenous area in Minnesota. I don't see people of different races anymore. It's not what registers to me. I see students that need help with their spelling. I see a John who really wants a hug in the morning. It's definitely expanded my world so much. I think everyone should have the opportunity to really be pushed to it.
Okay, so that's, for example, that's one of the girls who's in the program. Stop. Like I said, it's just a really great opportunity for, especially if you want to get into teaching or education. I know my friend who's in it, she wants to be like a principal, so she's working with kids every day, and it's just a great opportunity. So.
That's great. I wanted to do it because they have the advertisement or in NPR, they're always talking about CD year, give
mm-hmm.
a year, and... but I think I'm too old. So.
Yeah, they said city year. It's supposed to be like freshman,
right.
Sophomore,
mm-hmm.
junior, senior, city year. So
yeah, I'm way past that.
Senior citizen year.
Exactly.
Just kidding.
All right. Well, one of the articles that I found this week that I thought was really, really good is by one of my favorite bloggers, educational bloggers, Cool Cat Teacher. I follow her on Twitter, and I know we follow her here too in Learning Today and so forth. And basically, she's starting a series on social media and for schools. And this was one of the first ones she did about Facebook friending, like the 101 on Facebook friending. And she talks about how if you're going to be in education and if you have a Facebook, you're for sure going to have to learn how to make sure that your page settings are private for and have different options for your students, your parents, your other teachers, and then your friends and family. So she goes through the steps of different tips on how to set up those settings, and it's very easy. And then she gives a real life example of how there was a project they developed. And there was a student that kind of fell victim to cyberbullying, and so did you also have to educate your students on how to set up their page settings and so forth. So I thought it was really great. I'm going to continue to follow this series because I think it's really,
yeah.
really cool to learn, especially because she's using it all the time, and she's got really great advice for all other educators. So I'll have it on my notes there and check it out. But I love that she did a little graph on, well, not a graph, but like a diagram of how you kind of interact on Facebook with your friends and people and so forth. So, like, did you know that if you're friends with me and I have my settings that my friends can see, my other friends, they can see your stuff too?
No.
So, yeah, so that's called Friends of Friends. So she talks about how that's set up. And fortunately, I have mine groups very set up in their own little shells and so forth, because for that reason. So, but I'm sure that a lot of people don't know that if one of your friends posts something,
mm-hmm.
I may be able to see it, even though I'm not friends with them. So just so people know.
Very interesting.
Very interesting, yeah.
Okay, this week I highlighted some history-related iPad, iPhone apps, so I just wanted to talk about those. The first one's called Manual for the United States of America, and this one's really cool because you can actually read, like, some of the most important documents. So they have Declaration of Independence on there, Articles of Confederation. They have biographies of, like, Supreme Court justices and all different information. So I think it's a really great kind of supplemental tool to use with your kids if you're learning about that kind of stuff. The second one's Oregon Trail, just like the computer game. I remember I used to play it. So now it's on the iPad, and it's really bright and fun and interactive. But just like the classic game, kind of seeing how it traveling on the West and see all the stuff that went on there. Civilization Revolution is another one that's really interactive. And this one, you get to learn about different civilizations like Japan, Germany, China, for example. And you get to kind of like interact with other like leaders of the world and save your people. I don't know. That's a way to say it, but that's what
your citizens or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your people.
Okay. And then the last one, which we actually have on this iPad, which I'll show you quickly, is On This Day. And this one's really cool. For every day, you can get, like, for example, today's April 1st. So it's going to list all important events and
that happened
birthdays
on this day
and deaths. So if you click on, I can't read upside down, but so this says.
So here's the births.
What is this event? I can't read it.
The first one?
Any of them, it doesn't matter. So, Emperor, I can't read
Go
it.
Shaga.
So, if I want to know about
Japan.
That, there's a date. I click on it, and this whole article is going to come up about that.
From Wikipedia, it looks like.
Yeah. So, it's a quick reference to that event. And then, if you look on the birthdays, which I don't know if I'm there, so here's deaths. You can click on different people in history. It'll give the picture, and it'll give information about them. So, I think it's really cool. You can use it every day because there's all this stuff every day. And there's like 60 something.
Yeah, so here are the kind of cool facts that happen on this day.
Yeah.
I don't see anything about April Fools.
I know. Maybe right, it's a fake
cool.
holiday.
Yeah.
It's a current holiday.
Current holiday. So that's the one I found that I thought was really cool this week.
Great. Okay, so as most of you already know, Skype launched a Skype for Classrooms. We talked about it here on the show. We talked about it on our blog. That was kind of like their beta version, so
mm-hmm.
like the first version of that. And this week they announced that they're expanding the features in Skype for Classrooms to have different tools for teachers, because a lot of teachers are using it in their classrooms to bring guest speakers from other schools so that they don't have to travel and so forth, work with other teachers, work with other students, and kind of connect globally with different classrooms and so forth. So one of the things that they added was this thing called a project, and with that you're able to kind of search for different opportunities and help other teachers, or you can also find partners, teacher partners, so that you can swap and teach other classes and so forth. You can find classes that are happening in other countries even that are similar to what you're teaching, so that your kids can attend
mm-hmm.
that and so forth. So it looks really interesting. Currently there are about 7,600 teachers registered,
wow.
and about 200 projects that have been kind of signed up for. So the network is growing, and what Skype did is they saw kind of the need that educators had of connecting with other teachers just outside their own classroom and so forth. So they expanded on that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty exciting, and it looks like it's going to be a really great tool for the
yeah.
future. I went to their website, and they actually have a Google map with pins of, like, the teachers that have been registered,
everywhere.
And they're just
mm-hmm.
everywhere all over the world, so pretty cool stuff.
Very cool. All right, well, that's our show. We'll see you next week.